give me a minute. Just logging into the ServiceNow system. Okay. Okay. First of all, what is ServiceNow? Okay, anybody heard about ServiceNow? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So what is ServiceNow? Can anybody tell me? Anybody have an idea? Anybody who is already working in a company or something like that? Have you heard about ServiceNow anyway?
So when some companies using ITIL, then they are going to use ServiceNow. It is used for used as ticketing tool as well as a project management tool and so on. Like we are using ServiceNow since 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Okay. What do you do? What technology you work?
So I'm into SAP testing.
SAP testing. Okay.
Yes.
So, but you use ServiceNow for the ticketing, right? Incidents or requests come to you.
Yeah, yeah. As a ticketing tool, and we are using some around 8 to 9 modules from ServiceNow.
Okay. Yes, as you said, ServiceNow is a ticketing tool. At least it is started as a ticketing tool. Okay. So when we talk about
ServiceNow, not only a ticketing tool, but it can be used in so many ways. Like there are so many modules in that.
Yes, it started as a ticketing tool, but now evolved into so many other areas as well. Okay. So basically, ServiceNow offers ITSM, ITOM, ITOM we call it, ITBM. These three modules. Okay. Modules in the sense, there's a higher level modules. Under ITSM, we have multiple modules. Okay. And under ITOM, we have multiple. ITBM, we have multiple modules. We will talk about that. Okay. Whenever we talk about ServiceNow, there are other two things come up. Okay. Other things like it is an ITSM tool. Okay. as you said earlier, it's ITIL, okay, ITIL based tool, and also it is a cloud based SaaS tool. Okay, if you have heard SaaS, PaaS, SaaS means software as a service, PaaS means platform as a service. Okay, cloud means, can anybody tell me what is cloud means? Okay, so any application, right? For suppose you are using a SAP Finance, okay, or PeopleSoft HR, Salesforce, okay, any application, when you buy it from vendor, okay, he will give you that application. What is application means? Some software, some coding, something will be there. So there are two things are there, deployment model we call it. Two things will be there. One is cloud, another one is on-premise. Okay, on-premise means, let's say I bought MS Office. Okay, where I have to install? I have to install in my desktop. Okay, I have to install in my desktop, means on-premise, it is in my desktop. I will take that software and I will install in my desktop. Similar way, most of the SAP tools, now they are into cloud, but most of the SAP, most of the tools so far, okay, they are into on-premise. Okay, on-premise means you have to own servers, you have to install in your own server. Individual people, we use the computers, okay, but companies, big data, we use servers. Okay, servers also, it is like computers only. Okay, there is not much difference, it is a computer only. Okay, so we have to host application in server, means we have to download application into server. Okay, when you have application, what happens? You have to enter the data, right? All the data will be stored. You have to maintain data servers, database. Okay, and for the connectivity, you have to maintain all the networking devices. Okay, basic things we know, Wi-Fi routers, okay, firewalls, okay, all those things, load balancers, okay, all those different things also company has to maintain. Whoever wants that application, they have to maintain everything. Okay, to maintain server, we need technical people who know about servers. Okay, to maintain networking devices, we need the technical people. Security different, networking is different. Okay, this all cost money. Okay, and also for on-premise things, if the support is not good, it will go down. You might have, we are in banking application, I mean, if you go to the SBI bank now also, they will say server down, it's not working, application is not coming. You will hear this most, because mostly because they are on-premise solutions, there is not good support, they will usually go down. Okay, you have to maintain those things every day. Okay, if you want to maintain, you need to recruit people, you need to pay the money. Okay, so that is on-premise. You are hosting application, you are maintaining the application, whatever it is. Cloud means ServiceNow, Salesforce, these are the popular clouds now, AWS, Azure. Okay, these are also cloud-based tools. If you want, ServiceNow comes as on-premise as well. For suppose some government organizations, okay, some organization wants, if it is a on-premise, they can provide it. Okay, but ServiceNow, basically it's a cloud tool, cloud-based tool. It got its popularity because of that only, because if you guys might have heard about Remedy. Okay, Remedy, BMC Remedy used to be very big in ITSM. Okay, it is a ServiceNow competitor. Okay, but ServiceNow came as a cloud tool in ITSM area. So now Remedy and everything is gone. Okay, almost. Okay, whoever implemented already, they are using it, because again, because it's on-premise, you have all the servers, you are already invested in money, so they're still using it. But mostly, most of the companies already implemented ServiceNow and still implementation is going on for other companies. Okay, that is why it is in very good demand. Okay, coming to cloud. Cloud means you purchase it from vendor. Okay, purchases means usually we call it subscription. Okay, you pay monthly subscription based on the users, how many users using. Okay, what are the modules you are using. Okay, that is a complex structure. You don't have to worry about that, how the cost will be. Okay, so based on the, you will go to ServiceNow, you will write a contract. So this many users will use my ServiceNow. I need your instance. Okay, they will provide an instance. Instance means they will just provide a URL like this. You see, you are seeing this URL, right? This is ServiceNow. You don't see anything. Application server means wherever application is hosted, that is maintained by the vendor, databases maintained by the vendor, everything is maintained by the vendor. Okay, vendor means whoever, ServiceNow, company name also ServiceNow, they develop this tool. Okay. So that is means cloud means you are saving on all these maintenance costs. And also, since vendor hosting everything, he will manage it, he will maintain very good, that there won't be any outages. I have seen Remedy, there used to be so many outages. Outages means server going down, that kind of thing. But ServiceNow, you see, I mean almost zero. I never came across, I heard one or two occasions, but I never came across ServiceNow is going down. Okay, even when you are deploying, even when you are moving the code, it never goes down. Okay, first thing, that is availability. Okay, so, and also database, right? When you are, for suppose today there are 100 users, tomorrow there can be another 50 users might be adding. Okay, the database can be scaled up. Okay, based on demand, ServiceNow will increase your database. Okay, maybe there are 150 people. How many people will use at a time? Based on that, on demand it will work. Okay, they will automatically shift your traffic. Okay, wherever it is increased, wherever you are decreased. Okay, that kind of work they do, because they are providing worldwide this service. They can maintain, they can have a good people there. Okay, they are experts in it. So that is the difference between cloud and on-premise. Okay, you can go and you can just pay some minimal price and you can subscribe for it. Every month you will get the bill, you have to pay. Tomorrow you don't want, stop it. Okay, today you have 100 users. Okay, you will pay for this month, you will pay for 100 users. Tomorrow, 50 users, you will pay for 50 users. Okay, that is a flexibility with cloud tool. Okay, and another thing, we call it SaaS. SaaS tool means software as a service, platform as a service. Now, ServiceNow started as a software as a service, but now it can be called as platform as a service. Means, They will provide all the platform, all the applications, all the tables, everything out of the box. This is ServiceNow. Did I do all this development? No. All the tables, all the modules already there. Okay. If you want, you can make customizations, you can make configurations, different configurations, or you can build new applications. Okay. Any application you host on any web page, okay, you can create in ServiceNow. As simple as like a parking administration, for suppose. Okay, if a company has a parking administration where you have to register for parking, etc., that you can host in ServiceNow. Okay, any kind of application you can host. Okay, we call it custom applications. Okay, understood? And for suppose, if you have experience with SQL, other databases, to create a table, okay, you have to send a query, you have to create table, and you have to add fields, okay? You have to build everything. Here, just drag and drop, okay, you choose the table, you name the table, okay? You name the fields, okay? It is very easy to create. Okay, you can create table in 5 minutes, okay? In some cases, you create whole application in 1 day, okay? It is very fast to develop because all the framework and everything is already given. And one more advantage is you need minimum code, okay? Because it's a UI-based tool, okay? All the queries and everything is on the click of button or drag and drop, this kind of thing, okay? You don't have to, if I open this, usually in SQL or other database, what you have to do? You have to send a query, select from table, from something like that. But here it is provided, you just click. On the back end, they send query. On the back end, whatever the query they send, that is not our problem. So this is kind of query they send, but it is already built in on the back end, okay? That's why we call it UI-based tool. UI-based tool means anybody can use it. It's very user-friendly. Okay, without knowledge also, they can use it. Okay? That is another advantage. Clear? Cloud SaaS application. Then, ServiceNow is a ITSM. ITSM tool. ITSM means IT service management. Okay, abbreviation is IT service management. And there is another term called ITIL, IT infrastructure library. Okay, first I will talk about ITIL. Okay, that is a broader term, ITIL. Okay, I mean, if you want to go into ITSM area, it is good to do ITIL certification as well. Okay, you will get the resources you can do. ITIL means IT infrastructure library. Basically, what it does is for all the service-oriented organizations for the organization which are using IT landscape. Nowadays, every company uses IT. Without IT, nothing works. Okay? They provided some framework. Framework or best practices, we call it, or guidelines. Okay? This is not regulatory things. You can't see the screen share.
I'm using Android.
Okay, but go to meeting, you can see the screen in the mobile also. There might be some.
Okay, let me try out. Okay,
there might be some option somewhere. Okay.
Okay.
Anyway, where we are? ITIL. ITIL is a framework. Guidelines are best practices given to organization using IT. Okay, these are the best practices. This is how you implement IT. This is why you implement IT. Okay, this is the different areas you have to look at. Okay, there used to be, I think, 26 different ITIL processes are there. Okay, but now it's 33 are there. I think in this May, new version is released, ITIL. ITIL 4 is released, previously it is ITIL V3, okay? From 2011, it's ITIL V3. This month only, they released V4 version. In the new version, they changed some of the processes, some of the things, okay? We don't have to get into that. Anyway, so ITIL is they provided best practices for every company. It's not a regulatory, regulatory means it's not you have to follow, but whenever you want to implement IT in your organization, these guidelines, there are best practices, proven proven best practices. Those already proved that if you go this way, you will get the success. Okay. So that kind of information will be there in ITIL. Okay. You can Google up, you can read more on ITIL. This is not ITIL class, but ServiceNow belongs to ITIL. And then we have ITSM. ITSM is part of ITIL. Okay. Service management, okay, service operations, service transition, continuous management, service strategy. Okay, these are different things we have in ITIL. Okay. In that ITSM, IT service management is very important part. Okay, ServiceNow is a ITSM tool. Now also they call it ITSM tools. What is ITSM? No, the difference between AWS, ServiceNow is AWS, it is a, you can say infrastructure. Okay, AWS is not service. Okay, it's an infrastructure oriented. Okay, you can host your VMs, means virtual servers. You can host your network devices. Okay, you can host your database. Okay, you can host your application there. Okay, that is AWS. Okay, that is a infrastructure maintenance. Okay, ServiceNow is a, it is a mainless service. You don't host, you don't host infrastructure here. Okay, AWS, Azure, those are called as infrastructure. Okay. So ITSM, IT service management, there are mainly five things are part of ITSM. Okay, incident, problem, change, service request, then knowledge management. Okay, now I will give you simple examples. What is incident, what is request? We'll talk about change, these things later. Don't worry. For suppose you joined a company, okay, you have a laptop, or desktop, whatever it is, okay, and your desktop is not working, something happened, your desktop is not working, what do? You go and shout on the floor, my desktop is not working? You can't do that, right? Maybe it's 100 people working, 10, small group of people, you will know who can fix it, that kind of thing. And they also won't be having much work. Okay. So it's a bigger organization, thousands of employees, hundreds of employees. If you see big companies like Wipro, there are lots of people out there. Okay. 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs employees. Okay. In any organization, if you see a company like Apple, how many people is working on that? Okay. So in those big companies, when you get a problem, when you get a issue, I don't call it problem, I will tell why. Okay, when you get an issue, okay, there should be a mechanism where you can report that issue. Okay, there should be a usually traditionally what we should do is we used to call, okay, call somebody, they will direct to whoever the person repairs that and they will come to you. But you call somebody, they forgot, okay, or they remember and they forward it to somebody and they forgot. Okay, if they remember also, they didn't come. Okay, it took 5 days, 10 days. Okay, and also for suppose we talked about banking, right? Bank also, they use some application, right? That is hosted in a server. Okay, that server is down, some issue is there. Where they go, they have to report it somewhere. Okay, they have to report it somewhere. They have to record it somewhere that this problem is occurred. This issue is there. Okay, and there should be responsibility who will fix it, and there should be timeline. Okay, how much timeline it should be fixed. Okay, this is all will be provided in ITSM tools. Okay. Whenever you have an issue, you can go here, go to incident table, and you can raise an issue. Okay, if you call a service desk also, they will go to incident table and they will raise an issue, because you need to record what are the issues happened. Okay, tomorrow it will help. Okay, and once you create incident, it will be assigned to somebody, some group. Group means a group of people who will work on a similar issue. Okay, and it will be assigned to some person, and there will be SLS will be there. SLS means how much time it should complete. Okay, all these things will be automated or will be available in ITSM tools. Okay, and when we come to service request, okay, same example, you joined a company. Okay, when you join a company, you need a laptop or desktop. Okay, you need a desk, you need access to email. Okay, all these things will be there. Okay, but in the big organization, who will know you joined? That's why whenever you join, your manager or your HR, they will go ahead, they will raise a request. Okay, those we call it request. Whenever we need services, those are called request. Okay, it's a basic definition, remember it. Whenever we have an issue with a service, we call it incident. Okay, for both the things, we need to have a placeholder where we can raise it, okay, where we can track it, where it can be assigned to somebody. When we assign to somebody, means he is responsible to fix it. Okay, otherwise what happens? He will say he is not available, he will say he will fix it. You have to go. If you go to government offices, it happens every time. Okay, you don't know who has to sign that, you don't know who will give you that particular certificate. You have to roam around. Okay, so in private organizations, big companies can't afford that, because if your laptop is not working, company losing work, company is paying you to do your work. If your laptop is not working, if it is not fixed immediately, company losing money. Okay, and if server is not working, transactions won't happen, company will lose that whatever the transactions for that day, for that hour. Okay, how many crores that will be. Okay, that is the reason you need to have a ITSM framework. You need to have placeholder where you can quickly raise it, where you can see all the issues that are there, managers can see, and they will call the people, they will push the people to fix it. Okay, that is the simple general example I told you. General examples I told you in real time scenario. And okay, but why we need it? Why we need ITSM? Okay, for suppose. For suppose we have to, Hindi very difficult. I mean, Telugu, half of the people won't understand Hindi. Okay, I will try anyway. Okay, where are we? I mean, why we need it? Okay, why we are using, that is fine. But why? What is the reason for companies to use it? Okay, I will give you a simple example. We have Apple. They will what they will do? They will produce the phones, right? They will manufacture iPhones. Okay, they have glass screen. Apple manufactures that screen. No, you might have heard Gorilla Glass, Corning Gorilla Glass. Okay, so when to manufacture Apple iPhones, you need Gorilla Glass. Without glass, you cannot manufacture your phone. Okay, so whenever, so tomorrow something happened, whoever the company manufacturing that glass had some issue, their server is down, they are unable to do the production. Okay, what happens? Apple also, they cannot produce their phones. Okay, I mean, you might think that there might be already purchased, they might be in store, but nowadays no company will have those stocks okay, they will have a moving, okay, it comes, raw material comes, they will manufacture, they will sell it. If you hold the stock into your stock room, what happens? Let's say you buy 2 crores of stock. Okay, how much interest you will have in that 2 crores in 1 month? If you hold the stock at your, you will lose the money. So that's why they, that is some other business practice. Okay, don't worry about. But something happens in the gorilla manufacturing company, it will affect on the Apple, right? So whenever Apple gives contracts to this manufacturer, what they will do? They have to check, they have to make sure that they have the mechanism to, if any problems or problems do happen, whatever you do, it will happen. Okay, but when problems happens, how you fix it? Okay, how fast you can fix it? Okay, to determine that, they will check what processes are you have. ITSM process, do you have a ITSM process? Okay, how it works? Okay, what is your average incident resolution? Incident means resolving the issues. Okay, what is the average time you will resolve an issue? Okay, they will see all these. See, to get a contract from other companies, to get a business, you need ITSM tools. Okay, that is one of the big reason. And also for certification, okay, CMMI level certifications, other quality certifications also, they will see how, what are the processes you are have, ITIL processes or ITSM processes. Okay, that is the reason companies, every company, okay, maybe 50, 100 people working, maybe they don't need, they also use it, the some free software are available for basic.
Is CMMI full form?
Sorry?
Sir, CMMI full form kya?
Not sure, CMMI, we can Google it. Not sure. CMMI means, I don't know. CMMI abbreviation. Capability Security Model Integration. That is a business term. Okay. How good is your company to deliver a particular service? How good is your company to deliver a particular business? Okay. That is comes as a CMMI. Okay. For that, you need to have some certifications, you need to have a certain number of people supporting it, okay, so on, so on. There are some criteria will be there, don't worry. So now you understand the importance, right? Every company needs a ITSM tool or ITIL framework, okay? This ITSM tool or ITIL framework will be, can be provided by tools like ServiceNow, Remedy, we had service manager, I think Jira service desk for some extent, basic functionalities. Okay, these all are ITSM tools. Okay, in that ServiceNow is now a global leader, ServiceNow is number one. That's why we have, very high demand for ServiceNow. Okay, if you put your resume with some fake number, something, you will see, put 2 or 3 years experience, you will see how many calls you get. Okay. That is a demand for ServiceNow right now, because every company needs it. Okay, every company needs it. Without that, you can't do business nowadays. Okay, I've seen companies, big companies also, and using Excel sheets to track these issues. Okay, I have this issue. Okay, what happened? Manager every day in call, he will open that Excel sheet and say, okay, this issue, how far we are, what happened? Okay, they used to track in Excel sheets. Now they can do it in ITSM. Okay, half of the things you can automate. Okay, when you raise an issue, for suppose you raise the access request to a particular application, you can automatically grant it. Nobody has to intervene. Nobody has to work on it. Okay, it will take the details from here and it will send the details. It will automatically add it. We have systems, we have technology for those things. Most of the things what you get, password reset, access request, these things you will get, 30% of the tickets. Okay, these all things are, can be automated. Okay, you save so much money. Okay, I have seen the live example. There used to be a team who will work on the Windows servers. Okay, to install a server, okay, to install a server from the request they get to install a server, I mean somebody raise a request that we need a server with these configurations. Okay, from there to get approvals, okay, to install, okay, it used to take more than 30 days. Sometimes it's more than 1 month, 2 months. Okay, now with automation, what happened is almost 70% of all virtual servers, you can automatically create it. Okay, they will raise a request, and based on the request, we can send approval to somebody. Okay, and once it is approved, okay, it will directly go. We call it orchestration. Okay, it can directly send details to whatever the tool, like can everybody hear me? Hello. Can everybody hear me? Okay, I think it's problem with you. Somebody pinged me. Funny. I think it's a problem with you because others can hear it. Okay. What we are talking about? Sorry, forgot again.
Yes.
What we are talking about? Okay, that is why we use ServiceNow, ITSM, ITIL, Cloud, SaaS. That is the overall view. Okay, now let's come into the tool. So we already talked about why we use it. What is the purpose of using ITSM? Okay. Yeah, talking about server, right? You can automatically deploy the servers because AWS, these can have that provisions. Okay, you can send details to AWS. It will commissioning server or something. I am not sure what is the technical term. Okay, it will automatically deploy server. Okay, it used to take 30 days, 2 months. It now takes hardly 4 or 5 days. Okay, mainly that is also because approval you have to wait. Somebody to approve, because you cannot auto approve, right? Somebody has to approve it. That is the point of approval. Okay, and somebody needs to do the budgeting, all these things, cost, etc. Okay, those kind of compliance things will be there. That's why it will take 4 or 5 days. But it happens automatically. You don't have to do. Somebody has to monitor it. If it fails, again we have to do manually. But most of the percent, 60-70 of the percent, it will be automated. Okay, how much money company will save, right? That is one of the benefits. So many benefits are there. For suppose in ServiceNow, I talked about 4 things, right? ITSM, instant problem change service request knowledge management. We will go into these details. Mainly ITSM modules I will talk about in theory classes. Okay, then the ITAM means operations management. For suppose all the devices company will have, right? Okay, you will have servers, you will have databases, network devices, we call CIs, configuration items, or CMDB. Okay, all these devices you are maintaining, you need a full view. Okay, how they are running, then the server is down. Okay, you need a full view because you cannot, databases are hosted in some remote areas. Okay, databases or some devices. Okay, for suppose let's say a petroleum supplying company is there, their pipelines will go from somewhere. There should be some control system will be there, right? Everywhere some desert it will go. Can you every day go to desert and you will check how it is running, etc.? Okay, you cannot check. So you can monitor it. Okay, you will get that information in ServiceNow. We call it discovery. It will discover all the devices information. Device means computer, all those things. Device information, and it can show you how they are running. Okay, how is their health? Health means everything is running good or not. Okay, does it have heat problems? Does it have space problems? Does it have RAM problems? Everything you can use, view in item dashboard. Okay, that kind of things you can do. Means sitting at your desktop, you can see everything. Okay, you can manage every issue. Okay, of course, somebody has to work on that, but still you will have a better visibility. Okay, and you know which team to call, which team you have to call, okay, etc. Okay, I will take till 9:30. Okay, 9:30. We're almost done. I'm just giving the introduction. So that is item IT operations management. Okay, whenever a device is running slow or some performance issue, okay, some problem, it will send events, alerts we call it. Okay, logs, they will say I am checking the logs, server logs, means in the logs it will show warnings, all those things. Okay, then ITBM, IT business management we call it. Okay, IT business management, usually all the business applications like HR, finance, PPM, project management, these are the main things we have in ServiceNow. Okay, ITSM, ITOM, ITAM, and ITBM. These are the main things. Okay, ITAM, ITBM is recently added. Okay, 1 year back, something like that. ITOM is there, but is evolving. It is evolving now. Okay, but to get a job, you can say I worked on these ITSM modules mostly. You can say that. That's fine. Okay.
It is a totally cloud-based now.
Sorry.
It is a based on the cloud-based means cloud-based.
Means cloud-based. It's a cloud-based. Yes.
Yes, means cloud-based service, na sir?
Yeah, it is cloud-based service.
All this is a cloud-based service, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
All the modules, everything is cloud-based. Everything you will have here. When you purchase, you get only URL.
Okay.
URL and credentials. Okay. Based on that URL and credentials, you will log in. You will add other users, whatever you do. Okay, and let's come to ServiceNow. Okay, we talked about generally, right? Let's come to ServiceNow. As we already know, ServiceNow is a cloud-based tool. It is a ITSM tool. Okay, and it has ITAM, ITBM, all these modules. Okay, first when you purchase ServiceNow, okay, there will be minimum four instances will be available. We call it instances. This is a dev, where we do the development, test, where we do the testing. Okay, test at QA, you can call it whatever you want, you can name it as well. And production, where live, whatever the, that is a live instance. Okay, anywhere these will be there, right? Dev, any application, it will be same. Dev, test, production. And there will be another instance called high, where you can communicate with the vendor. If you have any problem with your instance, you can send it to the vendor. That is a high instance. Okay, companies can have multiple instances, multiple production instances. Okay, every department they can have different instance, and also I have seen multiple instances will be used. Okay, multiple dev will be there. Even if the production is one, multiple dev instances will be there, multiple test instances will be there. There might be staging instances. Okay, that is based on your contract and your need. The service of provide will as many as instances. But there will be a production instance and sub-production instances. Sub-production means dev, test, everything. Okay. Then basically ServiceNow has three roles. Okay, there will be different roles under that, but on the high level. One is admin. Admin means developer. Whoever codes, whoever configures, whoever customizes. Okay, they will have mainly access to the development environment. Then we have ITIL user. Okay, we call it ITIL user. ITIL user means whoever works on your issues, whoever fulfills your request, okay, whoever working in IT teams, those are called as ITIL people. Okay, they don't need all the access, they need access to whatever the things they work on, whatever the modules they can work on. And there is another role which is no role. People with no role called as a end users. These are majority of the people. Whoever uses ServiceNow to just raise a request, raise an issue, and see their request, see their issues, and communicate. That's it. They don't do anything. Okay? That is called as end users. ServiceNow mainly charges based on the role. End users won't be charged. Okay? They depends on contract, different modules. Now it is changed. End users also will be charged for some custom applications. Okay? But normally, idea is end users won't be charged. For suppose lakhs of end users using it for raising incidents request, they won't be charged as the users. Okay? Only people who is working on those issues, they will be charged. Okay? Let's say we have 1,000 people. How many developers you need? Admins, maybe 3 or 4. Okay. How many ITL people you need? How many people working in IT? Maybe 100, 200. Okay. So you will pay for only these 203 people, something like that. Okay. You won't pay for others. Okay. These are the main three basic roles. Remember it. Okay. Under ITL, there can be many different roles, but user with any role, we generally consider it as, for the business term, we consider it as ITL role. Okay, they can have any role. Okay, different tables will have different roles. Any roles, we consider it as a ITL role. Okay, or we can call it people with minimum role. Okay, now, as I told you, this is ServiceNow URL. Okay, when you type in URL in like any web page, okay, you can log in. Companies use a single sign-on for automatic login, okay, for production server. If not, you have to use your credentials and you will get into the instance like this. Okay, this is a home page, we call it. Okay, sorry. Here your company name will come, and here whatever they call it service, those services they call, whatever they call it, some call it IT service desk, okay, different things they call it. Okay, it's a business term, you can name it whatever the way you want. Here your company name will come. If company name is ABC, it will say ABC with logo. Okay, and here this is a navigation bar. Here you can search for anything. Okay, if you want to raise the incident, you can search for incident. Okay, general search. Okay, this is a navigation. Whatever the tables you have access, you can go here. Since I am admin, I can see everything. I can see all the tables, everything. Okay, and not only tables, but configurations also. If you want to create a script, you can search here and you can go here. Okay, whatever the things you need, you can. Okay, this is called as a navigation. Remember it. As you are going forward, you will see how to navigate everything. Okay, and here this is called as a banner. Okay, here it is showing whoever the logged in user. Here you can search anything. For suppose if I want to search an incident, I can search it. Okay. For suppose if I have an incident number, I can search here. Okay. If I have a request number, I can search here. Okay. This search box. There are different tools. You will understand what are those. This is the update set. As I told you, right? we have dev environment, we have test environment, we have production. You develop the code in dev environment. How we move it? Using update set. We capture whatever is in, we are developing an update set. Using update set, we will move it. Okay, we will learn about that as well. Don't worry. Okay, and here this is called as actual page. Okay, whatever. You will see whatever you selected. Okay, you can open in different tabs as well. If you open a different tab, it will show like this. Okay, this is how ServiceNow looks like. I mean, this is not a some demo environment, nothing like that. This is exactly what real ServiceNow instances looks like. Okay, but they might have different functionalities, different modules, or different colors, the way they configure. But all the functionalities, it's similar. In actually, in these instances, these are called as just developer instances or personal instances. We can, without purchasing it, we can have other modules as well. Some of the modules discovery, these things are license based. Okay, every company won't have it. Okay, we can download it and we can practice it. These instances are mainly provided for developers' practice. Okay. Once you join the class, every one of you will get an instance like this. Okay. Every one of you will get instance like this for your practice. You can keep it. Okay. You can keep it. You can do whatever you want to do that. Okay. And let me talk. Simply briefly about the overall architecture of ServiceNow. Okay. ServiceNow is called as based on the relational databases. Relational databases is, for suppose this is incident, right? In the incident, we have caller, we have configuration item. Okay. These different things coming from different table. On incident table, we need users. Who is raising incident? Okay, users are stored in a different table. Okay, users are stored in a central table, different table. Though that users table can be used in any other tables. Okay, so it is combination of different tables, and those tables can be related as you want. Okay, you can easily get data from other tables and you can relate it and you can use it. Okay, that is called as relational databases. Okay, it is very simple. Okay, usually some applications I see what they do is, if they want a particular field here, if they want to store information, so this is like information is pre-populated information, right? To store that information, they need to create another table and they need to get here. Okay, or if you create here as well, if you store this data here as well, what happens? It will take up more space. But if you have these things in centralized, can be used in any other table. One table can be used in multiple places. Okay? It saves space. When you have more space, you might have seen your mobiles. When your space is full, its performance is very low. Similarly, it will free up spaces, the performance will be very fast. Okay, so on relational databases, ServiceNow basically has three layers. Okay, one is UI. UI means what we are seeing, graphical user interface. Okay, wherever user interacting, what you can see, that is a UI. UI is based on the AngularJS. Okay, UI is based on the AngularJS, and you can see HTML, other.
Yes, sir.
Sorry?
No, sir. Tell me, sir. User interface, no, sir?
Yeah, user interface. It is based on the AngularJS and HTML. I mean, every web page needs HTML, CSS, these things. Okay? It is built on that. Okay? On the next layer, we have middle layer. Okay? Middle layer means from the web, you are doing whatever you are doing in the web page, right? You are sending request in the web page. Whatever information you send, you are sending using URL. Okay, this URL has to be processed and with the middle layer, and it has to go to the wherever database or wherever. Okay, that is a middle layer, and obviously we have database layer, database as well. Database, it is based on the SQL. Okay, it's a SQL database only. Okay, but we don't have to learn SQL. You never interact with database directly. Okay, whatever you do on the UI only. Okay, most of the tools, they will have UI for end users normally to see the data, to see the whatever it is. But ServiceNow and nowadays the SaaS applications or PaaS applications, developers also can use UI. UI means you don't have to do those queries, you don't have to do those codings to get the data, to get the things done, to do the configurations, customizations. Yes, you need to do some places. Scripting means you need to pass on the parameters. The parameters, they cannot, your own parameters, they cannot define in front, right? At upfront, they can define it. Okay, those parameters we have to send, those methods we have to call. But scripting also, every method, everything they already defined. For suppose Java or other languages, you need to build your object, data object, you need to build your function, everything you have to build it, method. Okay, but ServiceNow, it is already pre-built. You have to use those methods only. Okay, so it is, everything is user UI based, user based. Okay, for developing also it is easy. Okay, I mean with some knowledge as well, you can develop some knowledge about ServiceNow. You don't have to knowledge about JavaScript, all those things. Okay, to do the configurations, customizations, we use JavaScript in ServiceNow, not core Java, JavaScript. Web pages uses a JavaScript, right? Okay, ServiceNow uses JavaScript. But as I told you earlier, JavaScript has, ServiceNow has its own methods based on the JavaScript. Okay, we only have to know what is variable, what is function, how do you write if condition, these things. The methods and everything will be there. Okay, if you have experience with JavaScript, that is great. If you don't have experience with JavaScript, that is also fine. You don't have to come from the technical background. Okay, I am from the actually biotechnology background, not even BTech biotech, it's a BSc biotech. Okay, you don't have to have technical knowledge. Okay, that is the point of these SaaS based tools. Okay, without coding you can do whatever, the less coding you have, also minimum coding. Okay, that is simplified for you. Okay, you don't have to know about Java packages, Java objects. Okay, all those things you don't have to learn, and you don't have to write hundreds of lines of coding but to get a one function. Okay, if you want to learn JavaScript basics, it is good. Go to YouTube, search for JavaScript for beginners. I don't know how it is now, but when I learned it, there is something like there is a new Boston channel will be there on the YouTube. You can learn it. There are 3 minutes, 4 minutes videos, 30-40 videos. You can just go through the basics. It only gives the basic, why we use JavaScript. Okay, what are the, how we call function, how we call a variable, this kind of things. Okay, if you want to learn it. But in here as well, I mean, as far as ServiceNow scripting concerned, I will show you the examples. Okay, coming to that, how is class gonna be? Okay, I will show you. We will learn about ITSM modules. I told you, right? ITSM modules theory class. Okay, what is incident, what is problem, what is change, these things. Because when you join a company, you should know it. Okay, people are already working, they incident service seekers, they know for some extent. Okay, and after that we will learn how to create tables. That's the first thing. Okay, we will take a example, a use case, okay, requirement, and we will create a table. We add fields, we create fields, columns, and we call it applications and modules. We will see how we build these applications and modules on this left side. Why we need this is navigation. Without this, whatever you do on the back end, users cannot use it. Okay, and once that is done, we will learn about core configurations. Core configurations means, if you see, business rules, client scripts, dictionary, okay, notifications, UI action, access control. Access control means you can define who will have access to a particular table, particular field, particular application. Okay, field level also you can define. UI policies, whatever you see here, right? All these things we will learn about. Okay, that is the main configuration. Most of the times we'll go there. Okay, after that we will learn about data loading. In ServiceNow you can load the data. Okay, and reports. Okay, and other topics, update sets, other small topics. Okay, but these are main configurations. And in the class we will take real-time scenarios. We will take we will create a table. We will write the business rule. We will write the client script. So we will build whole application. When you complete class, we will have a whole application. Okay. I will show you how to write. I will write the business rules and show you each line. Okay. I will write the client scripts and I will show you. Now most of the training usually first time learners, what usually people do is just show you, okay, this is a script. Okay. This is how you write a script. This is how you work. Okay. But I will show you practically how to write it. Okay. Then end of the each class or end of the topic, I will give you some kind of assignments. Okay. Or whatever we did in the class, you do it in your own instance. Okay. I told you, right? Everybody will have their own instances. Okay. I will write every single code of line of this and I will show it to you. Okay. How to write it. Okay. I don't like it's not like I will explain this. This is a new value, this is a set value, not that kind of class. Okay. After that assignment, you work on your home. If you have any questions, ask me. Okay. Show me. Okay. That kind of learning you do. See, these things are, you have to practice when you are learning itself. Okay. Once you practice, you will remember it. Okay. Once I told this theory, you cannot remember it because this is a UI based tool, means click here, click there. Okay, these things will be there. Okay, if you don't practice immediately, you will forget. Tomorrow you will forget where to write a script. Okay, that is the basic things. You need to practice every day with the class. Okay, and at the end of the class, end of the overall training, we will see. Another training class, we will see how we, I will give particular requirements and you will develop your own application. And you can ask me, I will be available here. You can ask me any questions if you want. Okay. That is how this class going to be. Any questions? Timings and everything will be, InShoot will let you know. Timings and when will the class start. We plan to start next week. Okay. It usually will be in the morning, okay, before 8 to 9, something like that. We will see how it works. Okay, any questions about the class and whatever we talked about so far?
So I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
In the 11th session, we are dealing with content management, right?
Content management.
So I'm talking about the course contents.
Okay, content management is something else, so that's why I confused.
Yeah. So in addition to content management, I need service portals also.
Service portal, I can give you the introduction, but service portal development is completely different. You need to know Angular. Okay. JS, you need to know HTML. That is only for okay, advanced users. Okay, I can give you the resources where you can learn it. But this class is not for service portal. And as you said, content management is not used anymore. Okay. Before service.
Yeah, portal, that's what it is. Like content management is not. They are not using it, seems like, and they are using service portals, it seems.
Yes.
So one of my friends has told this regard. That's why I'm asking.
Yes, service portal. It came only recently. Okay, I think London, Kingston version, something like that. Okay, very recently. Okay, not many people know it. So in fact, I also haven't worked on complete service portal project, but I can give you the introduction. But if I give you the development also, you won't be able to understand. Okay, because it's AngularJS HTML. That is a completely different work. But I can give you the introduction, how it will be there, what is the different things will be there. Okay, it's not like you have to learn AngularJS, but if you can make changes to AngularJS, that is fine. Okay, but mostly out of the box, it will be provided. But remember, this class won't cover service portal development. Okay, service portal development or discovery or these things. Okay, because if I that needs another 1 month. Okay, I mean, if I want to cover that, I have to have a different class. But before that, you have to learn these basics. Without you learn these core configurations, you cannot go there. You're understanding, right?
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
First, learn this. Work on this. If you tell in the interview, I didn't get a chance to work on service portal. Nobody will say anything because they know not everybody got a chance to work on those projects because not everybody client, every client is not implemented it and it came recently. Okay. Or discovery and these kind of things or other ITBM modules. Okay. ServiceNow has many modules. In many modules, I mean, everybody is not working on every module. Whoever has experience on service portal, they might don't know about what is the in. They haven't worked on these core configurations. Okay. So you have to learn this class, practice it. After that, you can go for advanced classes. Okay. I mean, we are not giving advanced classes. I don't think anybody else is also giving, but I can give you the resources where you can do. Okay. Once you know ServiceNow core things, core basic things, you will learn on your own as well. Okay, you have the resources for that. You have the documentation for that. Okay, I mean, when I first started discovery project, I know nothing about discovery, but I know how ServiceNow functions. Okay, how to do the configurations. From that, checking the ServiceNow documentation, we can do it. That's not a big problem. Okay. Any other questions? Yeah, somebody asked, right? Somebody asked, do we have ServiceNow software for practice purpose? Yes, I told you, you will get an instance like this, ServiceNow instance. Software means you don't get the source code. Okay. This is a instance. Every one of you will get a personal instance like this. Okay, and you will get what you can say the documentation as well. Institute will give you those books. Okay. What else? Any questions? Any other questions? See, if you already know the core configurations, if you are only looking for service portal, this may be not the right class because we are not learning about service portal here. Okay. As part of ServiceNow, we will learn it. I mean, we will see the introduction. Okay. But this class is for core development. ServiceNow, we call it platform development. Okay. Whatever the module it may be, this will be used. Any other questions, guys? You don't have any questions? I will close it. Okay.
One thing. Like you're going to support for placements also, right?
Not me. Institute will support. Talk to the institute. Okay. Yeah, they will guide you. They will guide you and I don't talk in the recording, okay? But I mean they will provide some sort of talk to them.
Yeah. And one more.